Right. We're just getting into West Philly now. This is University of Penn. So this is like the nice part, or the one of the nicer sides of West Philly. These are all the rich assholes that are gonna run the country soon. You know, I kind of wish I would have went to college just for the experience. Oh, they have amazing food carts around here. My brother's isn't far from here, so sometimes I would, when I had the e-bike, I would jump in the car or jump in the bike and come over this end and grab some of these food at one of these trucks. There's a really good Vietnamese pho one back, we already passed it. Weird, you don't expect to have one of the best bowls of soup in a cart in West Philly, but it really is. I never came to West Philly to get drugs. When I was, you know, out here, one of the differences was there wasn't really an open air drug market in West Philly. It was, you know, you needed to call somebody. Man, that halal cart to my right smells so good. A lamb and chicken over rice. I don't know if you guys have those carts where you're from. But that's what they look like. Gyro cart. They are an institution here in Philly and New York. But you can get a platter with rice, chicken, a little salad in it, and a soda, usually for like $8. But you'll be able to see how quick the neighborhood turns here. Nice little strip to the left where there's a couple bars and stuff, and right here. A lot of this is the housing then now under University of Penn housing. This was University City, I believe, is what it's called. Or back there was. And then... you can tell this is all still housing. Student housing. When I started this is right when I got off the exit, the South Street exit on 76. So that's pretty much the end of University of Penn right there. And now we are going into West Philly. It was an 8-minute drive. Wow, that homeless guy back there had an old, like, AM/FM radio he was messing around with. Jeez, I haven't seen one of them in forever. I remember I was locked up with this. This is one of the main fares or throughways in West Philly, is 52nd Street. This is a very, very, popular intersection, 52nd and Market. Which way you want to go? Now, if you notice what's above us, if you see the train, this is the same, you know, this is the same track that the L is on, the Kensington train. See the skyline ahead, so we're not far at all from the center city. I'm gonna go down and then come back up a little bit down Market Street, which is where the L is, or the, you know, the train that runs along Kensington Ave. But you could see West Philly got these big old brownstone houses. Now, if I were to take this straight ahead all the way down, I would get to 69th Street, which is then Upper Darby. That's the end part of the L, the elevated line right here. Drive around a couple of the main roads right here, 52nd, 54th, Market, stuff like that. And then I'll go into like the smaller. This reminds me of Brooklyn a lot, actually, from like where my grandmother's from. I really don't come out this too often. This might be the fourth or fifth time I've ever been out this way. All right, you know what? We'll go down, we'll start doing these side streets, see. Actually, no, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go back down 52nd Street. That's what I'll do. You know why I love Philly? You could stop at any of these corner stores and get a better cheesesteak than you'll get at any at the best place in your city for cheesesteaks. Oh, Caribbean African food back there. There's a Rainbow store right here. at one in Kensington is closed though. 52nd and Market, you can see the West Philly's always been known as a pretty rough neighborhood, you know. Here in Southwest Philly can get pretty, you know, rough, as they say. I'm gonna go over there too. Slurped, that sounds like blowjob. That's a weird name. Slurped, all right. Go down a couple more blocks and then we'll, like I said, I'm just gonna take a lazy ride around here. Bruce, this is all like very known intersections in West Philly. Thank you. It's turned into a beautiful day today. It's like 60, so, well, it's gonna be 60 today. It's probably in like the high 50s right now. Yes. I'm trying to decide what I want to eat for lunch now. Exciting at night. That's what people are looking for. You know what? I should go left and go up to Upper Darby. See the end of this place. End of the L. I was gonna ride it, the whole thing, but I just got lazy. Mexican, American, and Caribbean food back there. Ooh. I might have to go back there, see what that's about. Oh, wait, never mind. I gotta go home and eat lunch today. I forgot. My, one of the guys I used to work with when I first got sober from Guyana. Whenever him and his wife make their chicken curry, they always call me and have me come get a plate because they know how much I love eating it. Gay Daddy Wasio? Looking at that. Sexy Bayou. I don't know what the hell that is. Cool graffiti though. Sixth and Market right here. I know a lot of homeless people who come to this, the place I'm about to bring you to now. They will sleep at 69th Street up here. Or at least the cops kind of don't mess with them as much, is from what I'm hearing. I used to never come out this way. There was no point. But as you can see, it's all painted nice, this down here. So they started this area and then, you know, went back, all the way back up. See though, down here is a lot of shops closed down here as well. Even this noon on a Tuesday, there's no reason for all these shops to be closed other than it's hard to run your own business, I guess. It's expensive, but I'm looking there left and right, there's all types of stores closed. Entering Delaware County. Right there to the right is 69th Street. I think. And now this, we are in Upper Darby. Small little, you know, suburb of Philly. This is 69th Street right here, my fault. That's right. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I was so confused right there. I'm like, what? I know this place. A lot of times what they'll do is they'll ride the train from Frankfurt, which is past Kensington, all higher up in Northeast, and they'll ride it to here and then turn around and turn around and take it right back, and it's like a 2-hour trip there and back. This is all Upper Darby right here. Oh wait, that's right, we're back in county. We gotta follow traffic laws again. That's what how people get screwed up all the time here in this area, is drive like an absolute asshole in Philly, and then as soon as you hit the suburbs, man. Going. It's like I'm out in the woods all of a sudden, just made one turn. is I want to go back into Upper Darby. Come on, go, 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 go. I'm going to do a U-turn right here. Come on, you can go. Weird, it's like this nature all around me, right in the middle of the city. This reminds me a lot of Pittsburgh, this area, being hilly like this. I actually really enjoyed staying in Pittsburgh, living there, until I realized or I found out how good their crack cocaine is. It's probably not a good idea to live here. I'd ruined everything. I owned a couple houses out there. I was doing great. And I found out about crack. You know what? I'm gonna go to the right here somewhere. Look at all the food places. Korean barbecue, H Mart. I don't know if you guys have H Marts near you, but they are freaking amazing. This one looks small. They're Korean supermarkets. They got the Paris Baguette, that place there, Paris Baguette. They make these curry rolls. It's like a donut type thing with curry filling in it. Oh my God. They are so good. Mexican grill. There's a lot of different little food places to eat around here, it looks like. Thank you. trying to think what else is over here I'd go check out. Or should I go right here? Yeah, we'll go right here. What the hell? Let's see what's on the other side of the tracks. But Darby seems all right. I know it has some problems here. You know what? We'll go see what's down this way. Right, see what's up this way. Oh wait, I think I went again. Yeah, I get stuck in by the train tracks. That's right, we'll just pop over here. Gonna be a lot better doing these drive arounds when it's not really nice out and people are out and walking around, you know. a lot of Mexican restaurants here. I think I'm gonna pause this for a little bit, try and figure out where the hell I'm going. Southwest Philly now. About to turn on Woodlawn Avenue. I'm kind of just making a trip around Philly. Different neighborhoods, just driving around. Just seeing what's going on. This is a very popular route, thoroughfare, Southwest Woodlawn Ave. Got a huge African community over this end. They got one of the best Jamaican food restaurants I've eaten in. And you can see they got the, what are those things called? The trains that are on the, wires above. Tram cars or some shit like that. Where is it? Right. I came out to a Ethiopian restaurant out this area. It was awesome. I'm trying to see where, trying to remember where it was at. It was right around here. Now there's a, I'm trying to see it as I drive by, I'll point it out. There's a Jamaican restaurant. There it is, right here on the left. Kingston. That that thing, they have viral viral Instagram posts all the time. Their food is good. I stopped up there. What'd I get when I was there? Jerk chicken, I think. Or did I get the oxtails? I forget. But this is Southwest Philly right here. The main thoroughfare, at least. Do a, you know, daytime drive around here so you guys can see what it looks like, but I gotta come back down here at night. Trolley, that's what it is. Jesus Christ, I'm stupid. And traffic can be a pain in the damn ass. to the little back neighborhoods here so you guys can see them. Southwest, man. This is considered one of the most dangerous neighborhoods in America. There it is, right there. Kingston, right there. Really good. Really good food. Jolliffe Town. You know her, and that's Nigerian rice jollof. There's a huge African American community here. On, I guess, further down. Trolley. These are the other two, you know, quote unquote, bad neighborhoods in Philly, West, Southwest, and North. Some girl back there on the left just threw a whole fucking soda on on her guy's face. You gonna play with me? Wow. I see some of the craziest stuff doing this. City right there, so it's, we're not far from Center City. It's one of the reasons I like Philly so much, is it's always, it's not far. You know, in 20 minutes you can get pretty much anywhere. I remember this guy putting away all that produce and stuff there. Man, I used to, working in restaurants, having to do that. It's a lot of stock to put away. I think this goes right back into University City and then over to my brother's neighborhood. couldn't tell what the guy, he was just praying. I couldn't tell what he was doing in the middle of that field to the right. That I'll show you when we get down there. There was a viral hot chicken sandwich for a while here in Philly. That's it right there. Assad's. It's like a Nashville hot chicken. The original one was at like a gas station in the Northeast. I go by it all the time. But oh, see, they're just, yeah, that one's just getting built, it looks like. Yeah, it's not even opened yet. But not bad. I like the Popeyes one's better, if I'm honest. Now we are, I think this is St. Joe's. If I'm not mistaken. Gonna be, yeah, this has got to be St. Joe's. Yes, I see a bunch of rich looking kids. Lunch trucks. This is definitely St. Joe's. I can smell that halal truck from here. Why is it so dead here and University of Penn was so crowded? Huh. I don't know. A bunch of my friends from high school went here. I used to have a big, a 6-foot nitrous oxide tank. I would come down to his parties, to their parties, and sell the tanks. should be coming up near the zoo, maybe? Or am I just that stupid? I don't know where I'm at. That's Woodlawn Cemetery there. That's a very old historic cemetery here in Philadelphia.